Welcome to Thrash the Trash, and in today's video we are going to look at the top 5 waste type which you can monetize, which you can leverage to create an impact or income or influence in 2022. Let's get into the video. Number 1, it's plastic waste. Globally, 300 million tons of plastic waste is generated every year, and whereas in India it's close to 10 million tons. These are the figures which have been accounted for. There is much more which are still unaccounted. And if you look at accumulated waste, it's more than billions of tons of waste which has got accumulated over a period of time. At one end, we are generating so much of plastic waste which is getting accumulated and hardly getting processed. And if you're wondering why, plastic waste is not that easy to process, to recycle. And the way how we are treating plastic, we are mixing it with other waste. Because of that, it's difficult to process, to recycle or re-engineer plastic waste. And moreover, plastic you cannot recycle more than 2-3 times. Beyond that, the quality of the plastic is eventually going to drop. And what is the solution for this? This is never going to come to an end unless until there is an alternate, a very good alternate or substitute for plastic product. Is there any such alternate or substitute? We are keep using a terminology called safe, suitable, viable, feasible, economical. Whatever alternate or substitute which is coming to your mind, just try to apply the safe. Is it suitable, viable, feasible, economical when compared with plastic product? No, there is no such product which is as good as plastic in terms of suitability, viability, feasibility and economics. Because of that reason, plastic is predominantly used everywhere. And there is a greenwashing trend to make it look like they are made eco-friendly plastic, like bioplastic, oxy-degradable plastic, to make it to showcase that these type of plastic can be decomposed, it can break down over a period of time. But even those plastic, they are not biodegradable. These are just falsified claims to avoid certain restrictions on plastic products. Whatever these bioplastics, oxy-degradable, even when they degrade, when they break down, it is going to leave a lot of microplastics which is eventually coming into our food chain and in turn is causing a harm to our health. And that is what is happening. And if you're wondering, I got it, there is so much of plastic out there. So how can I monetize, leverage this plastic waste? There are a couple of ways. If you want to create an impact and influence, then you can think about campaigns, awareness programs on plastic waste reduction, or coming up with sustainable alternate product which are more eco-friendly, which are more safe, suitable, viable, feasible, economical. And if you want to start a business, you can think about plastic recycling or even re-engineering, where the plastic waste is converted into a product, an useful product. More and more companies are trying to use recycled plastic in their manufacturing. That trend is going to change because there is a lot more pressure on the companies, on the manufacturers, on the producers, on the importers to tackle the plastic pollution. Number 2, we are going to look at electronic waste. Globally, 500 million tons of electronic waste is generated every year. And in India, as per estimates, it is 3.2 million tons. But as per the government, the governing agency, it is not 3.2, but it is rather 1 million tons. The ground reality. And out of that, how much do you think it's getting processed? Not even recycled, processed. Global and in any other country, if you take average, less than 20% is getting processed. Why I'm using the word process? This is something which I've talked about in my earlier videos. Because electronic waste, it goes through a different stages, from a brand new to old product to outdated to obsolete to waste. But whatever electronic product which is out there, it is not as waste as per these estimates, but it's somewhere being used in the value chain as a workable product, as a working product, or people are keeping it at home hoping it they will find a use for it in the near future. The predominant problem is that whatever electronic waste is there in developed countries, it is somehow moving to developing or undeveloped nation. Again, if you look at the developing or undeveloped nation, 90% of the waste is controlled by the informal sector, also known as the unorganized sector. They control majority of the waste management market due to variety of reasons. So because of the way they are handling the waste, the electronic waste, it is creating a lot of health problem, environmental problem. That is the biggest roadblock, a challenge when it comes to electronic waste, which the government, the international agencies also trying to address this particular problem. And what is happening of late, that companies don't want the product to get repaired, so they are trying to make the product non-repairable, so the customer can dispose the product and they can buy a new product. In that way, the companies can make more money out of it. Because of that reason, it is contributing to more electronic waste getting generated. If you cannot repair the product, then how can you fix it? How can you extend it? How can somebody use it? That is what is happening. The right to repair is something which is a hot trend, which is coming up not only in the developed countries, but even in developing countries, undeveloped countries, so that every consumer who purchased the product, who has purchased the product, has the right to get the product repaired. But the brands, the manufacturers, the producers, they are not happy with that because they don't want that to happen, which is affecting their profit margins. And if you're wondering, from what you're saying, there is not that much electronic waste in the market and 90% is controlled by the informal sector, then what is the point that electronic waste, or how electronic waste is in the top 5 waste? Let me tell you why. There is a huge opportunity, not only in terms of recycling. Think about repair, extending the lifetime of the product. So that is also an activity, a business which you can engage. And if you're not able to repair, then what you can do next is that the electronic waste can be dismantled into separate parts. Like the smartphone, you can separate the display, the battery, the circuit board, the plastic case, speaker, whichever is the working part, the usable part, that you can put it to use somewhere as a spare. So one is repair, the other is dismantling plus parts harvesting. It could be an IC chip, a capacitor. If none of the above works, like if you cannot repair, if you cannot harvest, then the last and the final option is to get the electronic waste recycled. Again, recycling is going to play a crucial role, if not now, but in the near future. Why? Because electronic waste has more than 25 metals, elements in it. And if you look at the geographic distribution of these elements, it is not available everywhere. Only it is available in certain places. And mining these resources, it requires technology, investment, which a lot of countries don't have. So because of that reason, these rare earth elements, these precious metals, these PGM, precious group metals, it is not easily available. It is creating geopolitical tension. So because of those reasons, recycling is going to be a game changer, so that metals and non-metal, which is there in electronic waste, that can be recovered and put to use into the ecosystem. Number 3, municipal solid waste. Globally, more than 2 billion tons of municipal solid waste is getting generated. It is nothing but your dustbin waste. And in India, more than 65 million tons is getting generated. These are just figures. These are accounted figures. There are still unaccounted figures, which will bring these figures to a much higher level. And out of that, how much do you think is getting collected? And how much of that it's getting processed? It's way lesser. 60-70% is getting collected out of these quantum, and less than 20-30% is getting processed. It is not the government fault, it is not the policymakers' fault, and it is not the international community's fault. It is because of the individuals, the consumers. We mix all type of waste together: food waste, plastic, paper, electronic waste, sanitary waste, glass, metal, everything we are mixing together. So because of that reason, what is happening is it is becoming difficult to process the municipal solid waste. If those waste are getting disposed of separately, then it would have made things much easier for processing. Then it would have gone down to the respective recycler or the waste management company for further processing. Since it is getting so mixed up, messed up, it is becoming difficult to process. That is why so much of municipal solid waste, it is ending up in the landfill. The only solution for such mixed waste is to convert them into energy. But again, do you think that is happening? No. When the municipal solid waste is so mixed, so messy, what is happening is that much energy, the calorific value, is not coming out of these municipal solid waste, which in turn is affecting the output, the whole business model itself. So that is why a lot of municipal solid waste is not getting processed. It is just left out in the open, waiting for a suitable, viable, feasible, economical technology so that one day it can get processed. Again, in the municipal solid waste, the informal sector is also playing a role. The rag pickers, what they are trying to do. Whichever is the worthy product, whichever, like a metal, it could be a glass bottle, a plastic bottle, they are trying to remove it from this municipal solid waste and trying to make a livelihood. But then there is a problem with that. They are getting exposed to these type of toxic mixed waste. Sometimes what is happening, medical waste like needles, syringes, that is also getting mixed with these waste, and they are getting scratched by these waste, which is affecting their health. And if you want to do something in municipal solid waste, one main and primary thing which you have to do is do something called the segregation at source. This is something happening in other countries, developed countries, but not in developing or undeveloped country, whereby the waste at the time of disposal, it's getting segregated, wet waste, dry waste. In that way, what is happening? Recyclable, non-recyclable. So whichever, if let's say there is a food waste, instead of mixing it with other waste, that food waste can be converted into compost, manure for plants. If there is an electronic waste, then it can be disposed of separately. The same go for sanitary waste, plastic waste. In that way, that is going to make things much easier in terms of reducing the municipal solid waste in the landfill. Whatever waste you are disposing of, it can be properly processed. That is going to be the game changer as far as municipal solid waste is concerned. And the other thing is to make people aware of living a sustainable lifestyle, lesser resource consumption, how they can live a zero waste lifestyle. Coming to the next one, waste type number 4, it is none other than solar panel. We are living in the world of renewable energy. We are trying to move away from fossil fuel. Fossil fuel or the traditional energy generation is creating so much of impact on the environment. It's contributing towards climate change, global warming. So we are moving away from fossil fuel and moving towards renewable energy. And solar panel is something not recently introduced. It has already been there as part of us. We have been using it for a very long time, and of late it has picked up and it is growing rapidly. Now there is a rapid adaptation, implementation when it comes to solar panel, the renewable energy. And generally if you take solar panel, it has 15 to 25 years lifetime. But then what is happening? Whatever has been implemented long back, decades ago, that is becoming obsolete now. That has to get processed. So more and more solar panel waste is coming into the market. And in the near future, what is going to happen? 5 years, 10 years, whatever has been put up before, that is going to come as waste. That has to get processed. But is that happening? Do we have the infrastructure to process solar panels? No. Because the lifetime is 15 to 25 years, the manufacturers, the importers, the distributors of solar panel are no longer concerned about the end of life solar panel, because there is a 15 to 25 years lifetime. So because of that reason, the procrastination. Now what is happening? More and more solar panel is coming as waste into the market. But there is no infrastructure, the capacity to process the solar panel. And again, if you want to set up a solar panel recycling infrastructure, it is going to cost money, technology. But is there a support, a subsidy, an incentive from the government? That is again a $1 million question, because that much is going to be the cost to put up an infrastructure to process solar panel. And that is another constraint, that the waste is given to the highest bidder. That is also applicable for solar panel, because the companies, the disposing agencies, they are expecting the best price for the solar panel. On one end, you have to put up the infrastructure without any much support. And on the other end, you have to pay a better price to get the solar panel. Do you think the economics is going to work out? And that is not happening. That is creating so much of problem. And eventually what is happening? The solar panels are ending up with the informal sector. And what they do with the solar panel? There are, let's say for example, we have mono, poly and thin film. Let's for argument, for discussion sake, let's take these mono, poly and thin film. In mono and poly, there is an aluminium frame around the solar panel. So what the companies are doing, they are just removing the aluminium frame to recover the cost, and the whole panel, it is just discarded without getting processed. And on the other hand, thin film, which requires technology, machinery to process it, and there is not much that you can recover with the existing technology. Because of these reasons, what is happening? There is no incentivization for someone to process the solar panel. What are they going to get out of it? That is again a very big question. But in the near future, so much of solar panel waste is going to come into the market, and there will be a lack of infrastructure. Coming to the next one, the waste type number 5, lithium ion battery. Compared to the other waste type that we have seen, plastic, electronic waste, municipal solid waste, solar panel, lithium ion battery is small, in terms of volume. It is gradually growing, but in terms of volume, it is small. Globally, lithium-ion battery, it's close to $50 billion market. As more and more countries are moving towards cleaner, greener, renewable energy, the adaptation of electric vehicle is growing exponentially. Two-wheeler, three-wheelers, four-wheelers, bigger vehicles, they are heavily using lithium-ion battery to push towards electric vehicle adaptation. Not only that, to store energy, we are heavily dependent on lithium-ion battery because of its efficiency. We are using in our day-to-day electronic gadgets, telecommunication, and so many other places we are using lithium-ion battery. Again, lithium-ion battery has a certain lifetime. After that, it becomes waste. The performance will drop, it will degrade, so it has to get processed. At this point, there is not that much of lithium-ion battery which is getting generated, especially in developing or undeveloped country. But whatever is getting generated, what is happening to it? Is there a sufficient infrastructure, a proper technology to process and recover the metals or materials from the lithium-ion battery? That is again a big question. Mostly what is happening, developed countries have bigger funding infrastructure to process lithium-ion batteries. So because of that, more and more lithium-ion batteries are getting exported towards developed country where they are processing and recovering the elements, material from the lithium-ion battery, which is not supposed to happen. If you look at lithium-ion battery, there are varieties, there are various types within it. And look at the elements, the materials, the metals which goes into the manufacturing. Where do you think it is available? Who controls it? That is a problem. At one end, we need lithium-ion battery to move towards cleaner, greener, renewable energy. But do we have the raw material, the infrastructure, the resource to implement it? No, we don't have the resource. The lithium, the cobalt, we have to get it imported from some other country. But who controls these resources? That is creating geopolitical tension. So because of these reasons, the lithium-ion battery has to be locally recycled, processed, and not exported to some other developed country. Globally, if you take lithium-ion battery recycling market, it's a $11 billion market. And in India, it's close to $1,000 million market. One is a billion, other is a million, and it is growing. And whatever infrastructure people are claiming that they are doing in terms of recycling lithium ion battery, just have a look, what are they doing? There are stages within recycling. Are they doing a complete end-to-end recovery, or is it going to be till a particular stage and then the output is getting exported? Is that the case? That is something that you have to look into. So there is so much of opportunity because there is a demand for these raw materials. And in the future, there is going to be more demand for lithium-ion battery. And there is also going to be generation of lithium-ion battery waste, which can be processed with a suitable, viable, feasible, economical technology to recover the elements, which can be used for locally manufactured lithium-ion batteries. So these are the top 5 waste types in 2022 where you can monetize, leverage to create an impact or income or influence. With that, we are closing today's video. I'll see you tomorrow with another video as part of the Thrasher Thursday.